Okay, guys, we're back with the boat. We are out here. I just got a power washer yesterday, so I did do a little bit of cleaning off camera, but I got it all cleaned out pretty good. What we're gonna do today is a lot of stuff. So today, like I said, we're gonna power wash. I got the charger and battery. This is a deep cycle, so I gotta use a starter battery for the other, but I'm gonna use this to try and lift the motor up and hook that up to charge it. So, but mainly today we're gonna be working on doing some wet sanding, cleaning, polishing. Make it look real good. We got some Meguiar's rubbing compound, polishing compound, and some cleaner wax. All right, I'm gonna show you how to do it right the first time, and then I'm gonna do the whole boat. All right, so without further ado, as we're back, we've got it all cleaned up mostly. That's not dirt right there, just to let you know. But anyway, this is what we're trying to get to. And this is gonna be our little test spot that I'm gonna show you guys, and then I'm gonna do the entire boat here, okay? But what we're gonna do, we're gonna start off with some soapy water. Gotta have your soapy water, right? Gonna have a number 20 wet dry sponge pad. I got all this stuff at O'Reilly's. P800, we're gonna start with. And then we got a 1500 and a 200. These go on a little sponge thing, but they all came in a pack of 1,000, 15, and 2,000. So, 1500 and 2,000 are those two. We're gonna do P800, 1500, then 2,000, all with the soapy water. We're gonna wipe it down, and then we're gonna polish it. They say what you wanna do with the 800 is mainly you want to get all this roughness out, right? And that'll get us down to the clear coat. So once we get down to the clear coat, then we will use the 1500 and the 2000 to smooth out the edges. And then use the polisher and rubbing compound to make it even smoother. So let's start with the 800. Start from down here, this is where I finished that. I think you guys can see. Let's see here. Right. Start out down here. Last time, see what's nice and smooth there. You need to spray, get you a better spray ball than I have, because my spray ball sucks. Just spray you down some area here. Make sure it's nice and clean first, because you don't want any dirt. Getting stuck in there. This thing sucks. Should have got a better spray bottle. Anyway, take our 800. Get both sides there. And we're just gonna do a rub, right? Straight rub. Yeah. Keep it going like that. You also want to spray down your sandpaper here. This thing sucks. I don't know what's wrong with it. Fix yourself, fool. That'll work. So what you want to do, you just take that 800. That down. You don't want to put too much pressure on it. Mainly just trying to get those scratches off. Keep the pressure even. Not scratches, but we're going to get down to the clear coat is what we're going to do. Get all down the edge here. spraying your water. Best to use a spray bottle, but it's drying out here too fast, guys. Okay, so we're just gonna do some of that. A lot of you are asking, is this the right way? And yeah, from my understanding, this is the right way. I did research on probably about 20 to 100 videos, and this one looks the most professional. And I'll link his video down in the description, but he does it pretty much just like this. 800 grit. 1500, 2000. He says you can go up to 3000 for something real smooth and nice, but I couldn't find any 3000 at O'Reilly's. This is getting real smooth, bro. Put a lot of pressure. You're just trying to get it nice and smooth. Get down to that clear coat. That's why you use a sponge. You don't want to put too much pressure. I've seen some guys do it without the sponge, so you can probably do it without the sponge. But I think the sponge is good. I use the sponge. Get out of here, B. Hey, B. I'm gonna mess with me, buddy. Get some soap on there. Sandpaper. It's looking pretty smooth there. From one spot to another. You don't want to go up ahead of yourself too much. Like I said, most of the stuff I know how to do, I did. I learned it on YouTube. Just about everything I know how to do, I learned on YouTube. I recommend just about anybody to learn some YouTube. This stuff down here is already pretty smooth, but we're gonna make it shine. But we're doing this. of doing a lot more than I thought I was going to here. Just getting carried away with myself. It's pretty smooth though. Getting into the flake a little. Is pretty good. Go ahead and pull it down some here. Turn that off. No good. Okay. Now you can kind of feel how smooth it is. Right? Feel it on the 800, you'll be able to tell. And on the 1500 and the 2000, it's gonna be more. I don't know. You won't be able to tell as much what you're doing. But let me get it looking good. That's pretty good on the 800 there, for that part. All right, now, let's get to the front part here. I'm gonna do the 1500 here. 15 is a little bit finer. Here. nice smooth surface here. Like I said, this is just taking out the scratches you just made with the 800. That's all this is doing. Feels pretty good to me. Here you do 2,000. And this guy, he says, you know, if you got metal flake, you want to make sure that you don't hit silver. If you start seeing it look kind of silvery, that means you've gotten to the metal flake and past the clear coat. Now, this boat is so old that there's already a couple places on it that are silvery and past the clear coat. So I'm not gonna worry about that for this one. But if it's something you're worried about, now, we're gonna spray it down. Now that it's sprayed down, come through here. Should have went ahead and marked that out there. But we're gonna come through here, let that dry off first. Right. You can already see how much smoother it is here. See that? But anyway, I'm gonna let this dry, charge my phone, and I'll be right back. All right, guys, phone charged up. All dried off here. All right. Now, what we're gonna do, gonna get our rotary buffer here. See, it's already shining. Alright. Already a lot shinier. Put this in. We're gonna do is we've got a different buffing compound for our buffing pad. But when I used it down there, it seemed to take off a lot more than I'd like it to. Now, what a buffing compound is, actually is pretty much like liquid sandpaper, to my understanding. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna throw on a nice fluffy pad, which actually we can probably just use this one. This one's probably just fine to use. Alright, we're gonna get our fluffy pad going nice and cleaned off here. And we're just gonna polish it. Now that I'm looking at this, I don't wanna buff it. I think we do want to buff it actually. So we do want to buff it. Because this back here turned out a lot better with that wool pad first. So, before you do any of that, I'm glad I did this for you before. You know? Put this on here. Put that wool pad on. Okay. Buffing compound does say not to or to do it by hand, but figure go nice and slow, should be okay. So let's buff it out. Okay, first of all, let's spin this out a little bit. This stuff, it doesn't have to be real perfect or anything like the other. Just kind of put some on there. Put a little bit on your area. Alright. Trying to smudge it around here. Now you want to start off around like a lower number just because you don't want to sling this shit all over the place. Alright, so. Sure you got it nice and smooth there. Start off kind of low. Yeah, that got off the scratch. It smoothed it out real good. now, get us a microfiber cloth here. Just wipe down the wool off of there. Now that we're done with the rubbing compound, we can take off our wool pad. Put our polishing pad back on. Now we're going to take our polishing compound, get us a rag, do this top part first. Okay. You said you want to start off slow. Do try to do this out of the sun though. I think that first day I did it, it wasn't in the sun. It didn't dry out too fast. But you guys can pretty much see how it's going. I think right there is where I stopped sanding, so not here. A lot more smooth now. A lot more color to it. Silver spots. Alright. My hands have been touching it. But it's a lot smoother. And this ain't to get it perfect, it's just to get it looking better than it was. So, pretty much here. This is how it did look. Alright, well, that's kind of banged up area. But, you know, you can kind of see how crummy it looks. It's rough, you know. I mean, there's a little silver in there, but anyway, this is how it looks now over here. So nice and clean. Almost see the reflection off of it there. It could probably be done a little bit better, but I think that's pretty darn good for a almost, what, about 40-year-old boat. It's not bad. In here. Look how nice and clean that edge is. Yeah, oh shoot. Look how nice and clean that edge is there. That's nice. Super shiny. Still gotta do some more polishing, but I think I'm gonna work on the top mostly. And then I'll get the bottom down. Some of this stuff. I'll get all this stuff later on. Yeah, we're gonna do some more wet sanding. I'm gonna set up the time lapse now that you guys have a gist of what I'm doing. You see how different that is? Even though the silver's kind of coming out there, That's scratchy. Anyway, I'm gonna set the time lapse now. You guys, stay tuned. Alright guys, it is a new day. We have finally finished all of the wet sanding and the polishing. It's a little dirty because it's sitting out here. I went and got the doors out of storage. They go here, here. I think I'm gonna have to make new chair doors because I can't find those anywhere. But anyway, today we're gonna finish up the waxing. And we'll finish this video. So I'm doing a whole thing here. I'm really glad how it turned out. It looks really good, really shiny in some places, still a little dull in others. But compared to what it used to look like, which I'm sure you guys know, it was like so rough. This looks like somewhere where somebody might have put something. I'm not really sure, but it looked so rough. Here's where it was already kind of into the paint here. So we got a little silver flake coming out. It's all nice and shined up. But yeah, there she is. Nice and shiny. Get her waxed up and she'll be ready to go. We are back here with the boat. My phone died a little bit, so I had to charge it up. But we went around, we waxed the whole thing, and now we're just gonna wipe it off with a microfiber towel. And I wanted to take you guys along on this part of it because this is really where all the hard work comes out. And you get to see exactly what you've been doing, you know? So we're just gonna take a cloth here. Just wipe away that film. Man, that is pretty. And protected from UV rays. This is why you do the wax, not because it helps make anything prettier or anything like that, but it helps protect. I mean, it does shine it up some, give a little clear layer, you know? But other than that, it just helps make sure that everything stays nice and shiny. And I'll have to wax it again after it rains on it about 100 times. So I'll just keep doing this part. So I really suck at holding the camera, by the way, guys. I don't know if you guys know this. I don't really do camera work that much. This looks really good. And at first I went over it and I was, I don't think I was putting enough wax down because some parts didn't really haze over very well. But I went back over it a second time, did some circular motions, and that part there probably needs to be. And I didn't get to wax all of it. And you guys know, there's some parts that I just didn't get to wet sand either, but they didn't really need to be wet sanded. So they were all pretty clean. And we'll get inside here. They got a little dirty after I put the doors in. Those doors had dirt all over them. Dirty place for years, but still though, looking very good so far. Sorry, looking really good. This on the sides. You just really want to let this haze up real good, and then you just kind of come around and rub it off. Get another microfiber towel because this one's got dirt all over it. Good thing I bought 50 of them just for this project. This stuff doesn't really come off with water. I don't know if you guys know that, but I tried washing my hands after this, and my goodness, it was difficult. I had to wash them like 4 times. Yeah, we just want to rub all this away with our microfiber cloth. And the reason I did this video, guys, I know there's probably videos out there like removing oxidation, polishing and stuff, but nobody really had a full video of like their whole boat being done. So I wanted to do the whole boat, show everybody the work that it takes, the amount of days, the amount of time that it can take to do an entire boat. And I didn't even do the whole boat. I only really got the top part done here, but it's mainly just to see how good it can turn out too, you know? You want to make sure that your boat's going to be able to look nice before you put too much into it, right? See, here's that fiberglass work that somebody had done. And when I sanded it all down, it actually made it come out pretty smooth. It's not perfect. You know, guys, like this is, like I said, we're getting this out on the water by April. So I got about 2 weeks left, and we're actually gonna be out there around I don't even know what day. It's like more middle of April. So I'm gonna get it done by then for sure. Get all that wax off of there. Dried wax there. Keep wiping this all off of here. Switch the camera around here. See all this freaking branches or whatever from over there. I feel like this is like maybe day four. And actually, I have other things that I do too, you know. I couldn't really work on this on straight days in a row, and the wax and everything likes to have, you know, not much sun out here. You don't want to have it dry on too fast. So I had to wait for a day like today where it's cloudy and but it's turned out really good. I mean, compared to how it used to look, guys, you guys know. Like, my brain is exploding with excitement just on how good it looks, you know? It's just freaking so cool. This is how boats are made, to where you can just, you know, wet sand them and shine them up like this. Almost look brand new. We got some wax on the rub rail all the way down there. Yep, at this top part here. And like you can see here, I figure right here is where they were kind of stepping a lot, where all the silver's coming through. And I sanded it down, but couldn't go too far because it would have went too far in, you know. So yeah, it's turned out really good. This part here probably doesn't need too much work. It's really this, like I said, which I think I'm just gonna put my hand through the holes here. See, there's a hole here. I'm put my hand through there and just kind of pop that away. All this off. And I see that, you know, I got some stress cracks here. Nothing too much to worry about. You know, this is, I bought this boat for $500 when I got it. So it's one of those things that it's gonna look as good as whatever you put into it, you know. And if you put in a lot, then it'll look pretty darn good. Look at that shine. Wow. The best way to hold the camera is by like looking in it, right, to see what you're doing, but it's hard to see what you're doing. Like I said, you just want to wipe this all off and just get it nice and shined up and pretty. All of this wiped off. top here. This looks so good. Hope you guys approve. Because I give it at least an A-. At least. Some of you might say, no, B+, bro. B+. But I'm going A- all the way here. And for how old this boat is to look this good, it's amazing, you know? It's so much fun doing it too. I freaking love doing stuff like this, making old stuff look good. And it's really just a hobby of mine, you know? I like doing a lot of things, really. If you guys have any questions or comments, you know, put them down there. You know, if I didn't explain properly something, you know, just let me know and I'm gonna try to do better, you know? I'm gonna try to do better at all of it. I got me a PC that I do all my editing with. I've been thinking about doing a how to build a PC video. I mean, there's so many of those out there, but there's so many of these too. And I think everybody likes watching a lot of videos to get as much information as they can, you know? And there's things missing from some videos that should be there. And I'm not saying I'm perfect, but I'm trying to add something. That's not around, you know? Man, that's pretty. I love the green. I mean, I'm colorblind, guys, so what you guys see is green. I see differently, is what I've been told. all my friends and family members, they tell me exactly what green is, and I say, okay. Sometimes things don't look green to me, and they're perfectly green to everyone else. And I don't know my greens or my reds. I mean, I know them. I know what everyone else thinks is red, and then I know what I know is red. You know, some people. Some people just, I can't even comprehend it, you know, because it's like, what do you mean you can't see green? And I literally can't. I mean, I see, when I see green, I see everything but green, you know? I see what would be there if green was taken out, you know? Like, if you have like a slider, like on your computer or editing software or whatever, I don't know what you guys do, but if you had a slider and I think you can even do it on your phone or whatever. Anyway, if you had like a slider on a picture, right? And you took that picture and took all the green out of it. That's essentially what I see. Except, not really, too. It's, I don't know. Just ranting because I'm working. Hopefully you guys aren't bothered too much by it. Just thinking about stuff, you know. This stuff, you know, this type of work is almost simple, you know, to where you gotta have other things on your mind when you're doing them. You're doing work like this. Been pretty manual work oriented since I was a kid. So, you know, I just keep going and think about other things usually, but I mean, it's hard not to think about this thing because it's so darn pretty. My goodness. All right, that's almost the whole boat there. We're almost done, guys. Sorry, this freaking video is fucking long as hell, probably. But it was fun to make. That's why I haven't had a video out in a little while, because I've been working on this and working on moving into a new house. Not really a new house, it's a fixer-upper, if you know what I mean. So, there'll probably be some videos on that soon. Putting in a new front door and stuff like that, you know. Sorry again about the video camera. I really suck. I'm not like a selfie person. I don't really glamorize my appearance too much. I don't really care to. I don't like photos, honestly. But, you know, it's just the way it is. Whew, I think we're done. Just about. I feel like I got, oh yeah, let me do this. Wipe this down. I need another cloth. Nice shiny that is. Went in too early, but yeah, you know, that's the good thing about this is that, you know, if you mess up anywhere, you can always go in, re-wet sand, as long as you don't get too deep and into the very bottom of the fiberglass through the paint, which you probably would be pretty tough to do, you know. So anyway. Oh, yeah. A lot of work. I'm building up a little bit of a sweat here. Breaking a little sweat. Whew. Almost there, though. It's all about endurance. Whew. Man, I gotta get those doors out of there. Look how raggedy they are. Sand those down. Probably the next thing I do is sand that. Sand the floor. Do the carpeting. And I might have to, I can't find the things that go on top here. I feel like it used to be just chairs and they just sat on top of there with a piece of wood, but at the same time, it's hard to believe. I don't really know. Oh man, I keep forgetting the camera's upside down. But anyway, that's next after we get done with this. But I think we're pretty good now, guys. So I'm gonna do, I'll go around the whole boat here and show her off to you. You know what I'm saying? Gotta show her off. Shoot, I suck at holding the camera, man. I look down and I'm like, looking at the freaking dirt. Okay. Whew, that's pretty good. I'd say that's a job well done. Look how shiny this is. Look at that. What do we got here? Yeah, that is shiny and it's nice and smooth. Real nice and smooth. Like I said, this stuff ain't gonna come off with the oil of your hands or water. I mean, it is. I'm getting this towel over here. Just wipe her down as I go one more time here. And like I said, I didn't really get to wet sand up in here yet. You know, middle of the boat still isn't fully wet sanded. But top part here, part that everybody really sees, you know. This is all, ooh, look at that freaking shine, guys. Look at that, you can see the freaking tree there. Wow. Man, all right, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna pat myself on the back. Pat myself on the back two, maybe three times. Okay? It's gonna be great, guys. I might cook a steak or something. That's how I celebrate. Some of you out there probably T-bone? Heck no. Ribeye, baby. It's the only way to go. It's got the perfect amount of fat, marble in it. You guys know what I'm talking about. If you're an entrepreneur of steaks, or whatever you would call it, you know what I'm talking about. Steaks are real. You know? Love me good. Oh, ribeye. All right. Sorry, I'm kind of goofing, guys. I just so excited about this. It looks so darn good. You know? But I think that's it. It's going to be the end of this video. I hope you guys like this. If you did like, go ahead and subscribe and everything for more. Got a lot done here. So, stay tuned for more episodes on the Skeeter. And we'll see you guys next time.